it's SGU, and we're back with our MLB The Show 17 Franchise Mode Series featuring the Los Angeles Angels of Anaheim. Wanted to take this time right here to kind of give a little bit more in-depth look at the rosters, not just in the majors, but in our minor leagues as well, because we've got to check out our prospects. Now, we've talked in the comments section a bit about how the Angels are lacking some real big name prospects. They don't have any A potential prospects in the minors, but we do want to take a look around. And hey, it's Manny Banuelos, who is missing from my Braves roster when I carried over that roster into franchise for this year. It's interesting that he's there. Why didn't he stay on my roster with the Braves? I don't know. But we're just kind of looking around here and see, first of all, our starting pitching prospects going all the way down in the organization, even the Class A guys who technically don't get to play games. So if those are guys we want to develop, they got to make sure to be on AA or AAA rosters. But we'll get to some of that as we look around. We're now into our relief pitchers here. So I'm just going to kind of give you a look at what is in the system, both in the majors and on the farm. One of the things we're going to have to discuss, and that I really do want some feedback from you guys about, is how to deal with guys who are currently injured in real life. Specifically, Andrew Heaney should be right there in our rotation if we are going to ignore the fact that he is having Tommy John surgery and not on the roster. Now, he is one of our prospects. He will be back. Do we want to impose a ban on him in the first season and bring him back the next? How do we want to deal with players like that? We also have, I believe, a first baseman who is out, not for the entire season, but he's on the DL 4 to 6 weeks to start the season. And so that's another situation. Are we going to make him sit out for a while? We're talking about Valbuena there. He's listed in A ball because he is currently injured coming into the season in real life. So I don't know. What do you guys think? Maybe there should even be a poll, or you should definitely tell me, if nothing else, in the comment section below. Do you believe that we should hold out players like Andrew Heaney and Valbuena because of injuries? By the way, there's one of our bigger prospects, Matt Theiss. I'm a little interested in him because everything I read coming into the draft is he's drafted as a catcher out of the University of Virginia. Well, they've got him listed at first base now. Did they do a position change with him? I haven't read anything about that, but that might be the case. We're going with him as a first baseman right now. Kind of looking through our other middle infield prospects, and boy, a lot of C talent out there. The cupboard's a little bare, as they say, with prospects in a lot of these positions. Once you drop down from the major leagues, or some cases even in the major leagues, we're not really cracking any top prospect lists, as we saw last time when we looked at the top 50 and we had nobody there. Now, you see Torii Hunter Jr. That's kind of cool. I know he's kind of a reach as a prospect right now. Played football at Notre Dame, but he is Torii Hunter's son, and that gives me some feeling of wanting to push his career forward the best that we can and keep the family name going. So Jamai Jones, I know some people brought up Jamai Jones as, where is he in the prospect list? Well, when I showed the AA and AAA lists, he was not there because he's listed in A ball. We're going to definitely get him on at least a AA roster so that he is progressing in the game, because he is one of our top prospects, he and Matt Theiss. So we got to make sure that that is rolling along and we are getting him groomed for the majors. So now that we've looked position by position at what's in the organization, it's time to turn our attention to opening night. Now, we've started at a surprising 3-1 to start the season. We'll take that, taking 3 out of 4 from Oakland. But now we come home to play the Seattle Mariners 2-2. So here at Angel Stadium, and we got this nice MLB Network graphic overlay going on. I turn that on more often than not, but it is nice that there actually are 3 broadcast styles, or is it 3 plus the MLB Network? I think it's Broadcast 1, Broadcast 2, and then MLB Network. So it's nice to see some different overlays and some different choices to kind of make some games feel more special than others. Feel like a national broadcast as opposed to a regional broadcast, those kind of things. So the Angels going through all their home opener pre-game ceremonies, but now it's time to give the ball to Jesse Chavez and see how he does on the mound. Last year, 2-2 record. Let's see how his first start of the year goes. He's got a little trouble in the first inning, runners at the corners, but he does induce a ground out to second base right there and gets out of the inning with nothing coming across the plate. So Mike Socha is going to be fielding this batting order here for the home opener. And you see Cole Calhoun, the one that is struggling the most here right now. Also Cameron Maben hitting 214, but yeah, hitting in the 100s there. Cole Calhoun, we'll take a look at him later, but this is a leadoff smash into the left field corner, should be extra bases, and Escobar is on with a double. Nice way to start the bottom of the first, getting the leadoff runner at second base, but now with two outs and after a Mike Trout strikeout, which I'm doing all too often with him so far, Pujols strikes out as well and strands the runner eventually at third base. So neither team putting a run on the board early. Chavez dealing here, and he gets a strikeout to end the inning looking. Mariners not so fond of the call right there, but Chavez is dealing. Just one hit aside here through an inning and a half. We now go into, I believe this is the fourth inning, when we get a fly ball out to Mike Trout in center field. He should be able to handle that no problem. Inning over. The early innings for Chavez going well. You got Calhoun, Trout, and Pujols coming up to the plate. Speaking of Trout, he's going to atone for those strikeouts, hit this ball deep to right field, and it's not coming back. I believe the announcers mentioned he hit one the day before when we simmed a game, so he is starting to heat up. You saw his batting average, despite all the times he struck out with me controlling him, is in the 400s early on here in just a handful of games, so I don't think anyone's going to be worried about Mike Trout's performance and what he can deliver for our ball club. You know what? He is MVP material. So we're going to focus our concerns elsewhere, like Cole Calhoun's slow start out of the gate, and we'll just let Mike Trout do his thing, like crushing baseballs the opposite way, just like that one. Okay, so 1-0 Angels on the big fly from our star player. Let's see if Chavez can hold this down. Two runners on, and oh, this is slicing to left, and whoa, that got out quickly. New ball trajectory on display there as it really sliced away from the outfielder, giving him no chance to track that thing down. It goes over the short wall, and it's a three-run shot for Kyle Seager. Not the longest home run, but he definitely hit it hard and also opposite field, as this thing keeps slicing towards the line and towards the pole. And all of a sudden, that strong start for Chavez kind of gets turned upside down with one swing of the bat. Cole Calhoun said he was struggling just over 100 with that average. Now he just needs to line up a baseball and hit it hard. He does that right here down the line, but that's going to stay up and be caught. So I'm not saying everything he's hit has been hard, but when he does, he's kind of snake-bitten right there. That's frustrating to say the least. This is even more frustrating for the Angels, as that's a two-run bomb way out of here. It finally lands out near that outfield landscaping. Deep shot. I'll like to see the tail of the tape on that one. 440 feet for Segura. Man, two-run homer makes it 5-1 Mariners. And we're not going to see where this thing lands again, but we are going to see some swing info on here. I don't think we get to see exit velocity and all that, but we get to see where the pitch was and the timing. Yeah, that's the kind of stats we'd see in previous years. I want to see that exit velocity and the angle on it, all that newfangled stuff. Here's a base hit with two runners on, and now that lead runner is Pujols, so he's not even going to try to score on that play. We don't need him getting thrown out at the plate. Down four, but with the bases loaded, this is going to be put into play to left field. And even Pujols should be able to tag up on this. Here he goes. Runner tagging to third as well. And we get one run closer. It's now 5-2. Doing some damage, at least a productive out there. So we got one out in the inning. And wanting to drive home more. Runners at the corners. That is off the pitcher. Seager's going to find it. Throw to first base, and he gets the out very alertly. Another run does score, making it 5-3. But Seager is trying to make sure it doesn't get any worse. With two outs here, this is going to be put in play to right field, and that looks like that is going to be out number three of the inning. So we get two back and make it 5-3, but we got some more work to do in the late innings, and that includes shutting the Mariners down and keeping them off the board any further. Well, this is a problem because this is hit to left, and that is also trailing away towards the line from our left fielder and hops one hop over the fence for a ground rule double, setting the table for the Mariners to possibly tack another run or two on here. and get a big inning and break this thing wide open. So runners at first and third, one out, a little bloop swing, and well, when you're going well, that's what happens. RBI bloop single to right field. It's now 6-3. We fast forward to the bottom of the ninth. We've got a runner on and Maben at the plate, and he hits the ball right at the shortstop. There's one. There's two. Pick at first base. Game is over. So we drop the home opener 6-3 to the Seattle Mariners. We're now 3-2 on the season. A little frustration in the dugout there, but it's early, guys. Don't get too down on yourselves. We got a long season, and we got some rebuilding to do around here. So don't expect things to be smooth every day. We've got a lot of work to do, like I said. So speaking of the work we have to do, that includes looking at what we got going down on the farm, and I do want to do some spotlights on our prospects, and we're going to go down to double A ball with the Mobile Bay Bears today, and we're going to check out the aforementioned Matt Theis playing first base. Now, like I said, he was drafted as a catcher out of the University of Virginia, so I'm assuming somebody's got some intel that they're playing him at first base now, and that maybe that's more their view of a need with him. As you see, flies out here in his first at bat while we're player locking on him this game against the Chattanooga Lookouts. So playing first base and getting routine plays here. He can just step on the bag himself, but we want to see more of him at the plate and what he can do. He seems to have pretty good contact after controlling him for a game. I feel like he can square up the baseball pretty well, like right there, a solid single to left field. I like his swing. His swing looks really nice. Now, obviously, these guys are created in the Operation Sports full minors rosters, so whoever was in charge of the Angels got to put as much info into this as they could as far as the prospects, their batting stances, their looks, all those things. So, you know, we'll kind of trust some of that. I watched a little bit of tape on Matt Theis, at least what's available online from around the time he got drafted. So that ball hit to right field. It's going to be caught. And he is out. Chattanooga up 2-0. Here we go back out to the field. And once again, he's going to get a roller. He's just going to backhand, step on the bag. No need for the pitcher to cover. Handling that one ourselves. So 1-for-3 with that single in the fourth inning. He'll get one more at bat here in our spotlight. Let's see if he can make a count. Runner on third base. Nobody out. 3-2 count. And he's going to go the opposite field with that. Fairly deep. Left fielder will make the catch. This should score a run and make it a 2-1 game, and it does. So sacrifice fly, so doing the little things right there. Mobile does lose the game, but there is a quick spotlight on one of our prospects, Matt Theis. We'll try to take a look at others as we go along in the franchise, but here we go. What do you guys think about the injured players? Play them or sit them for this year? Let me know in the comments. We'll see you next time.